Finger fluttering probably isn't going to be as nice as normal. I have one finger out of action. We'll just ignore that. I wish I'd filmed this before getting this looked at, but we'll make do. I'm sure I can still write. Today, I thought that we might do some writing. I'm gonna take you through some planning that I have in mind. I'm going to Japan in a few months. It's still a while away yet, but I'm the kind of person who needs things planned out. I need to feel like I'm in control. I don't want every second of the trip planned. I just need to have a good idea what general places I want to be visiting, on what days, so that I can book tickets and stuff in advance. So today, I'm going to try and work out what days make the most sense to do what activities. Good news, I can still write. All is not lost. Okay, so the cities. Oop, this is a bit trickier than normal. The cities that we're going to. I'm going with my best friend. We're gonna go to Tokyo. Kyoto. Osaka. Nara. Got about 3 weeks to fill with fun activities. Since we're getting into Tokyo first, we're trying to be in Disneyland on the 31st of October. Here is the roughest calendar grid you have ever seen in your life. Days of September, April, June, and November. So that's first. We come home. 27th, we get to the airport. It's a midnight flight, so technically we don't leave till the 28th, but gotta be there a couple hours early for an international flight. And then this is home. We get in at like 11:30, I think. It's late at night. So if we're wanting to be in Disney for Halloween, that's gonna have to be locked in. Disney L, because we're going to Disneyland and Disney C. I think that we might want to go to Disney C towards the end. We start off in Tokyo for the start, and then we move on to the other towns after this, and we're back in Tokyo for a couple of days before we leave. So we arrive in Tokyo. On my actual one, the cities will just be color-coded so we don't have to write this. I've been to Japan before, a couple of times actually. This will be my third trip. Last time we went, the accommodation wasn't booked the whole way through. I went with my little brother and we didn't know exactly where we wanted to be when. I had a vague plan, but he wanted to keep it a bit looser. And we could only end up staying one night in Kyoto, because everywhere was booked out. It was a super busy weekend for some reason. So I'm glad that we've got 5 full days to enjoy it, almost full, because that's our transit day from Tokyo. If you've been to Japan and not been to Mount Koya, I highly recommend it. It has a huge necropolis. It's got 300,000 tombs. It's the birthplace of Buddhism in Japan. On top of a mountain, there's like a valley where the village is, in the shape of a lotus leaf. A lotus flower, sorry. It's very mountainous and green and if you've not been to Hiroshima or you're planning to go, definitely go to the museum. It's really intense. It's beautifully presented. Upsetting but important. Definitely recommend you go. Alright, so here's my finished rough sketch calendar. You can see Tokyo appears to be a lot of time. Some of these days that are marked as Tokyo, I can't bend that finger. Tokyo. They're actually going to be day trips outside of the city. We've got a couple of cities that we'd like to go to, places, natural places. We're gonna go see Mount Fuji on one of these days. I personally think that Disney Sea, I don't think we want it in the first week. If we're already doing Disneyland, that's a bit overwhelming. But we don't want to do it on the 16th because that's a travel day. 17th might be really crowded because it's a Sunday, so maybe the Monday would be the time to do it. That's a big day right before we go home, but I've done it before. The first time I went to Japan in high school, literally the day we flew out, we went to Disneyland. We flew out that night. I reckon can go out with a bang with Disney Sea. I think that'll be good. So, first day, we'll be excited, probably want to see some stuff. I think that we should hang around where we're going to be staying. Around Shibuya, have a look at some gardens. I think that'll be very peaceful. I think the next day we should go to Harajuku for a nice big day of shopping. I want to go to Kiddie Land. It's a big toy shop. It's really cool. There's some lovely gardens. I think the Meiji Garden is around Harajuku. So we'll go there, we'll make a day of it. It'll be lovely. I think we'll want a rest day after Disneyland. So that should be something without much walking, if we can handle it. Or at least where we don't have like something that we absolutely have to get to at a certain time. So I think this should be a day trip to one of the cities that we wanted to go to. I think this should be a day trip as well, because they take a bit more walking. This should be a rest day. Rest day doesn't mean you don't do anything, it just means you take it a bit easier. Our feet are going to be killing us from Disneyland, probably. And that's our last day in Tokyo. Let's walk around Shinjuku on that day. These are all very loose. These are not going to be locked in. The only things locked in, things that we need tickets for. So, Disneyland and Disney Sea, for example. All of these days are just whatever we feel like on the day, we'll just do it. Depends on our energy levels. Kyoto, the first day, it's just gonna be like a half day. So this is a wander around. First thing on a Monday morning, I want to go to the Golden Pavilion. Golden Path. It'd be nice to go to the Imperial Palace. And gardens. Our accommodation is right next to it, actually. Which would be really useful. Not right next to it, but like a couple blocks away. Which would be great. I'm not sure yet what we'll do these 2 days. Probably just wander around. We're going in October, November because the autumn leaves in Japan are gorgeous. We don't really have that many like maples or anything like that that are like really heavily deciduous trees that go beautiful orange. Like, we do have them, but not like Japan has them. And Kyoto, last time I went, was the most beautiful. I was there in November. It was so gorgeous. I was so upset that we had to go, and I was sick when we were there too, so I didn't get to explore nearly as much as I wanted to. That'll change this time around. There's a heap of shrines. So I'm sure we'll just... one of these should probably be a rest day. Where we just take it easy. Don't know what we'll do here yet. Osaka. I didn't really enjoy Osaka that much the last time I went. I don't know why. Just didn't sit that well with me. This is a travel day technically, but it only takes like an hour, maybe two, to get from Kyoto to Osaka. So I think that we might try and go to the aquarium on this day. No, you know what? We'll go to the aquarium on one of these days. We'll have a wander around day. I think it's important when you first get to any city when you travel, and it's what I did with Europe as well. The first day you get there, you put your bags away in whatever place you're staying, and you head straight out the door and have a wander around and try and get your bearings. And you can like spot restaurants that you might want to visit while you're staying there, or parks, or activities, museums, all that sort of stuff. It's just nice to get your bearings. On this day, I'm staying in Osaka, but we're actually going to take a day trip to Nara to visit the deer. Last time I went, a deer ate my map. Will forever forth be known as Map Eater Jones. I have a picture of him chomping on my map. It was very rude of him. They're quite aggressive. It's really funny when you watch the deer chase someone. Alright. We're going to Koyasan, which I'm very excited about. We're staying, hopefully, in a temple, a Buddhist temple, right next door to the necropolis entrance, which will be sick. I stayed there last time. It was incredible. You get fed traditional vegetarian Buddhist meals by the monks. It's just an amazing experience. They have traditional baths in the temple as well, which was really cool. I'm excited to go back. It's beautiful walking amongst the graves as the sun was setting and the fog started rolling in. It's very cold because it's on top of a mountain. We might get snow. I think it'll probably be a bit early in the season for it, but you never know. To the necropolis on the first day, since it's right next door, and then the next day we'll explore. We only stayed one night last time, didn't really get a chance to look around the town that much, which was a shame. There's so many temples, but not this time around. Next, we're gonna catch a train, Koyasan, back to Osaka, into Hiroshima. Travel day. So we'll do a little explore. Just have a wander around, have a meal. We'll try and go to the museum if we can. We're staying pretty close to the atomic bomb dome. And the museum. That shouldn't be so bad. On the next day, I want to get a ferry out to Miyajima Island. It's got a beautiful in the water floating red gate. It's not actually floating, but it looks like it does. It's very beautiful. You get a little ferry out there. There's deer all over the island. That'll be fun. I don't know why they have so many deer in Japan. And then we head back from Hiroshima to Osaka. And we're gonna go to the... We'll see how big of a rest day that is. We might have another little explore day. / shopping day. There's lots of good shopping in Osaka. The next day, they've got an enormous aquarium that I didn't get to go to last time, but it's meant to be like world class, just enormous. I'd really like to check that out. And then we head back via bullet train from Osaka to Tokyo. Have a little explore. We'll probably be pretty tired. Alright. And then we've got our day trip from Tokyo. We might go to Fuji then. We might go to Fuji then. We'll see. And then DisneySea, and then we'll come home. This is a jam-packed trip. I really hope that we'll be able to get everything that we want to get done. I hope that it has been a calming experience for you to watch me plan some of this stuff out. Because it certainly calms me down to be in control and organized and knowing what's going on. We'll see if this plan actually ends up being what we're doing. I need to show this to Kirsty and get her confirmation that it looks good. Because even though that I like plan so much, it's not just my trip, it's her trip too. She needs to feel good about everything that I've come up with, but we're pretty similar travel style type of people, so I think that this will be fine. I'm so excited for this trip. Hopefully I'll be able to film some videos while we're over there, because the gardens are gorgeous. Anyway, that'll do us for this round. I hope you have a very lovely day or night, whatever time it is for you. And I will see you next time.